Good morning. Sorry for starting late. The last talk was cut quite close. My name is Markus Meissner. I'm an OpenSUSE member and I'm a Novell employee. And standing here in front of you to talk about a bit about the free Windows emulator or the not emulator Wine. Just some words about me. I'm working for SUSE since 2002. I'm not working on Wine for SUSE. I'm working on the topic of security, but security in itself is boring and you can't show pretty pictures. So I'm showing what I do in my spare time. So in my spare time, for now above like 14 years or so, I'm working on a Wine and yeah, so I'm going to tell you a bit about it and also will hopefully show some demos at the end. So the first question that people ask or that I ask myself is, why would you want a Windows emulator on Linux? Every one of you knows that we have a full set of applications already, like the Office Suite is there, tools are there, games even are there, some, not much, but there are also a lot of tools already on Linux, and you usually don't need Windows programs. So there is, however, some software not really ported because the companies don't have the strategy to port them. That's foremost true for Microsoft themselves. That's true for like people like Apple, who acknowledge that Microsoft exists because it has 95% market share, and of course there are macOS stuff and Linux. Yeah, we've heard about it, but there are no users that we are interested in. Second part is budget. That's mostly true for the game companies who want to push out games, and if they work on Windows, they don't really have time to spend on doing a Linux port or so, because all the programmers have Windows at these times, and those Linux users are there. They are not really important. Or they just don't care. Or Linux, too small. Come back if it's 50% market share or so. And we address all those, or we try to address all those people that don't want to port their Windows applications so in that way that you can run their applications on Linux. Second question is, why not just use a virtualized PC? Why not just use VMware or however, whatever it's currently called, Parallels or whatever? Most obvious pro is that there's no Windows license necessary for using Wine. Of course, at the same time, a contra point is that the completeness of Wine, since it's developed continuously and we don't have access to any Microsoft internal documentation, it's of course not complete yet, so not much might run, built. A pro point is that it's integrated well into your system, while a virtual PC emulation is mostly in a fixed window and you can't move easily data out and copy and paste or so. It's possible with Wine. desktop integration like icons, like shortcuts or menu entries and so on for specific Windows applications. Fun, of course. Of course, you know, I will show that we have working on this for 16 years now, and we're not really doing small things, but doing quite an amount of coding, and it's huge. Of course, replicating the Windows operating system or the ability to run Windows applications is a huge effort. Microsoft continues to add features to improve on their APIs, and so we are, of course, always continuing to catch up. We might never catch up, but the interesting thing here is that Microsoft also has the compatibility problem. If an application runs on XP, then of course this application has to run also on Vista. And if people build this application, they ship it, and it doesn't run on XP anymore, it needs Vista, so of course, their customers also want a bit of backwards compatibility. So at this time, the catch-up curve is not so high anymore as it was when Microsoft started with 32-bit Windows, 32-bit Windows. Now with 64-bit Windows, we are seeing a slower migration rate of the programs and customers, so there isn't so much a steep curve for this. Of course, we have not everything implemented yet. Yeah, as I mentioned, the completeness part. So, yeah. So, to give some overview, nearly 16-year-old old, out of a random ID on a Linux kernel mailing list. Yes, why not just run 16-bit Windows programs on Linux too? So, and now we are here. We had the first stable release last June. No one expected it that we finally would do it, but well, we just took a certain set of criteria and said, yeah, now it's ready for the users to test and to run. In the meantime, before that, we had over 200 alpha releases, 61 beta releases, so we had 2 years of beta phase, 5 RCs, and on June 17, it was released finally. We are, not stopped working on it. Development is proving, is going as fast as before, even faster. I think we are working on a 1.1 branch, which will in the end go to a 1.2 stable release. I will talk about some criteria for this later on. Over time, there were over a thousand offers that we could identify. It sounds much, but in reality, what we see is that at any given time, there are like 20 to 30 people working, sending patches. People drop off, new people come, people just send one or two patches. So, but overall, there are 1,070 contributors. It's picked up by various companies. There's the company called CodeWeavers, whose business is really improving wine, selling wine via their crossovers products, and they actually employ a large part of the wine developers, including our chief developer.